Assalamu alaikum kids, how are you all? So our today's topic is about word problems. As we have learning about multiplication and division, we can do multiplication and division in solving word problems also. Okay, teacher can ask you, teacher can write a question, a big question full of words, and you should know either it's multiplication or division. Let's see. But some students say word problems make me nervous. Word problems, I just skip them. No, it's not that much difficult. Don't worry, with just four easy steps you can become a word problem whiz. Let's see. Step one, understand the problem. What are you trying to figure out? Here is an example. Yesterday Alex saw 14 birds in his backyard. Today he saw 12. How many birds did he see in all? In this problem, what are you trying to figure out? Means in this problem, what they want to actually ask. Let's see. If you said, how many birds did Alex see in all, then yes, you are right. We can say that this question is asking for you to add them up. Let's see. Again, the question, Alex saw 14 birds in his backyard. Today he saw 12. How many birds did he see in all? That means you have to check how many birds in total he has seen. Okay. Step number two, get a plan. How will you answer the question? Should you add or subtract or multiply or divide? Okay. If teacher asks you, if teacher say, I have given, for example, 12 candies to Muhammad and he has to distribute each candy to the student, and you have, for example, 6 students in your class. So how Muhammad is going to distribute the candies? Think, either it's multiplication or division. Yes, you are right, it's division. That Muhammad has to divide the candy to 6 students, and total candies are, for example, 12. So how he will divide 2 candy to each student. Okay. Look for the clues. Here are some clue words that will help you to decide to do. If they ask you what is in total, what is in all, how many candies he will be distributing. So these are the things that are giving you hint. That means clue that either it's multiplication, division, subtraction or addition. Now let's coming to this question that has been written for you. Yesterday, Alex saw 14 birds in his backyard. Today, he saw 12. How many birds did he see in all? Now, you can see the clue words. They ask you in all. That's mean total. Now, the words in all tell us that we should add. Now that we understand the problem, we have a plan. We are ready for the next step. Let's see what is the next step. Step 3. Solve it. Write a number sentence using the information in the problem and work it out. Let's see. Give it a try. If I say, yesterday Alex saw 14 birds in his backyard. Today he saw 12. How many birds did he see in all? Write a number sentence and solve it. If you wrote 14 plus 12 as it is given in the question, 14 and 12 equal to 26, then you are right. Let's see. Now, step 4. Look back. Does your answer fit the question? Our answer was, Alex saw 26 birds in all. Yes, it makes sense. Here are the steps once more. Step 1. Understand the problem. Step 2. Get a plan. Step 3. Solve it. Step 4. Look back. Now, the word problem will be, I hope, easier for you.